Alright, hello and welcome. This is The Legend of Korra, a new game released today on the 21st of October. This is the first thing I'd like to note right here, is this isn't on the Steam page, that little notification that says you should use a controller. I don't think that's on the Steam page. Super suggested, most likely. I'm not going to try the keyboard controls because I feel like they won't work well no matter what. I've tried recording this once before, which is why it kind of probably sounds like I'm in a little bit of a hurry to get through this opening part. In the options menu, we have pretty limited options. Controller, vibration, on, off, that's it, that's all you got. Camera, pretty basic stuff, inverts. Sound, also pretty basic stuff. And under display, we've got fairly normal things, resolution, full screen, graphic quality, brightness. The interesting thing about graphic quality is it only says normal or smooth. I have no idea which one of those is, like, better quality, so I just left it on normal. I assume smooth means like it makes the game run smoother. I don't know, it's kind of not fantastic, whatever. It's not descriptive, it could probably be better. Not a big deal. That being said, $15 title, ton of options. While they would be really nice if the game is good on its own, then that's fine. Another thing to note, I have only watched Legend of Korra up through the first season or book, so I have seen the entire first season. I know this game takes place after book 2 and before book 3, so I have no idea what happened to book 2. I have no idea if there will be spoilers. If you're worried about that, I might put an annotation up if I even know if it's a spoiler or not, if it happens. So, now that we have that all out of the way, I have not begun playing yet. So we're going to start it up. I will skip cutscenes because I am more worried about the gameplay, because this is a Platinum game and I had high hopes for this game coming out, as it seemed like they were trying to do like a very good job, and it kind of seemed like what I would want out of a Legend of Korra game, because I really like the animation and the fighting in the show itself. So, without saying anything else to elaborate, let's get started. Alright, new game. Normal seems like it will be just fine.
Fire. Air. Water. Only the Avatar.
Okay. Only the Avatar. Some crazy shit, probably huge spoilers. Oh shit, okay. Water has some severe range. Okay. They waste no time.
Let's do this.
I have a taunt. That's my favorite.
Water.
Okay. Whoa, okay. How do I switch? Okay. Maybe less time trying to figure out how to switch between them would be fine. Oh, it just switches them automatically. Okay. 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 Oh, okay. Fire is very quick. Oh, well, okay.
Only the Avatar can master all four elements and bring balance to the world.
That's interesting. Okay. Oh. Okay. So I was supposed to get overwhelmed there, I suppose.
No!
Okay. We are off to a strong start. Alright, 1 week earlier. Skip all that stuff. I will be watching that later. It's not that I don't care about it, I just don't want to spoil anyone accidentally. Okay, fantastic.
Oh.
I got knocked back one. Oh shit, they move in. Fuck you. Okay, there we go. Okay, fuck you guys. Okay. Interesting. Okay. Now I can press my advantage. Do I win? Is that a win or a loss? Oh. Okay, yeah, just continue.
Let's give this another shot.
Sorry, still getting used to this. Coming off of Evil Within, it is not a very easy transition. I'm getting back in my groove pretty quickly though. I say as I get my ass handed to me. Okay, here we go. Damn it. I got one of them out, though. This should be much easier. Okay. There we go. Okay. Okay. I have spirit energy, evidently. Okay. Oh, nope, skip story stuff. Oh, everything's locked. Okay.
Air Temple Island. Maybe Tenzin can help me figure out what's going on.
Hold it, Avatar.
Hello, random goons. Oh, and not so random goon. You look evil as fuck.
I cannot allow you to leave now, Avatar.
Oh, it's gonna be one of these.
I might not be able to bend, but my fists still work.
Okay. Oh, okay. I have a finishing move type deal. Oh. That's fucking cool. Okay. I can get with this. I got a gold medal for that fight. I feel like I did terrible.
Amon's gone. Why are the chi blockers still here? That old guy must be calling the shots. But who is he?
I will refrain from breaking pots as much as I possibly can. I really,
Not another step, Avatar!
But, What's up, fellas? Ow. Okay, there we go. The movement is really good, and actually even fighting without bending feels pretty okay. That opening, though, bending seems like it is quite powerful and good. Hello, random enemy man. Camera problems. Okay, there we go. Oh, okay, fuck you. Right now I feel like not locking on might actually be better. Just because these tight quarters don't really service the camera too well. Health? You can find various vanity items in chests, ranging from common objects to very rare ones. Wow, that's unfortunate. Where'd he go? That looked breakable. Okay, that's interesting. Oh, found a health item. Awesome. Fuck you. Okay, much better. Alright, now I'm getting the hang of this.
Chi blocker has never blocked my bending for this long before. I feel like my chi is completely gone. What did that old guy do to me?
Probably fuck my shit up. There we go. Okay, there's a chest down here. That seems worth it. Maybe not. Okay. Alright, that opens more. Oh, gonna jump like up and on top of. Okay, whatever. Okay, a couple more. He disappeared. What's up here? It's gotta be something, right? Shit. Oh, nice. Please unlock airbending to continue. I like and hate that.
Okay, which way to Air Temple Island? I should ask someone on that street for help.
Fair enough. Nice. So far, Korra seems pretty fast and responsive, as I would like.
I know who can get me out of this maze. Naga!
Okay.
That's actually a move I really want to block, just to see what the, There we go. Alright, got you. Do the running attack. That's not the running attack I wanted to see. Do now? Fuck you. Ha, firebending only barrier. Oop, I assume. Can I? I can. Wow, I can totally bust up cars. That seems unnecessary, but I appreciate it. This way. Hello, enemies. Goodbye, enemies. Alright, there we go. I should be able to get past that later.
Can you hear me? Naga!
Oh. Okay. Come get some. Yeah! Let me get some. Oh, now there's a bunch of you? That's super satisfying. Blowing them away. That was fantastic. Alright, I will watch this one as it seems like Naga is just going to show up. Yep, there you are.
Naga, the girl.
Okay. Oh shit.
Okay.
Gameplay section.
Going, Naga.
Oh, nice. This is a fun little section. I'm okay with this. I'm curious to see what spirit energy actually does, though.
Quickly, Naga.
Fair enough. I'm gonna jump. Okay. Oh, fuck. Yep.
Time to get serious.
I did not press jump fast enough. I was building up like good speed too. Left. Ooh. Section's actually pretty fun. I can really appreciate a good section like this. Yeah, here we go. That was pretty nice. Okay, that's enjoyable. We going? Okay. That's pretty enjoyable. Bonus spirit energy, alright.
I have always honored to help whenever I can.
Alright, whoops, sorry about that. A little bit of weirdness. Okay. You can access the spirit shop by pressing Y on the chapter select screen. Press Y. Fair enough.
Hello, Korra. I may have
something
to make your journey a little bit easier. But remember,
I have not seen him in the show yet, so I guess he's a spoiler. This item is consumed. The Korra is revived at full health. No, I don't want that. Wow. Jeez, never get stunned ever. That one didn't seem good. I guess I'll buy one of these. Might as well. And then, I'll buy two of these? They're 1,000 each. That's not much. Halves your attack power, doubles the amount of spirit energy you earn, get rich fast. Could be good. I will save that for later. That's a personal preference thing, so I will leave it on completely baseline. Oh, Korra's room can be accessed by doing this.
I'm home.
Da-da-da-da.
Items before I can use them.
Down on the D-pad will be fine for this. Okay, so we've got some pretty good combat strings, it seems like. Fairly simple, but I suppose that's sort of good in some ways. Costume change? To unlock this, you have to enter the secret code on this screen. Interesting. Okay, so we've got a secret code, and extreme difficulty, and any difficulty. Okay, so we've got some costumes. That's fun. I think we're done here for now.
Let's go and get them.
Having extra costumes, always fun, though. Review, but okay, let's move on to the next chapter where I will hopefully reacquire bending so I can do some stuff. I'll just start through this.
Chi blockers beat me to Air Temple Island? How is that possible?
Okay.
That one looked expensive. Come on.
Collect 4 jars of spirit water. How do I collect them?
Whoops, I think that was Pema's favorite.
These? You want me to collect jars, but you don't tell me what they are. They must be up here. They'll probably be blatantly obvious whenever I... Oh. Really? I wonder if they're blatantly obvious. Is that it? Is that not it? Okay, no, that's it. Okay, good. That's new. There we go. Oh, okay. Alright, fuck you. Okay. New enemy types. I guess I'm headed all over the island. Oh, good. Fuck you guys. I'll fight you later. Oh, they're not even chasing me. Oh, with water bending. That's unfortunate. Looks like I'm headed back to fight these guys. Seems my combo potential is a bit limited while I don't have my bending. Okay. Here we go.
Getting closer.
Spirit water. Got that. Oh, I saw another one.
I'm so close. Just a little more spirit water.
Fuck you. Okay. I assume the spirit water will give me my water bending back. Or at the very least, that's what I'm hoping it's going to do.
Okay, seriously, my bending's never been gone this long before.
It's not up in front of that, is it? No, it's not. Oh, it's across this. Okay. Hello, singular enemy. Hello, singular enemy that will actually kick my ass super hard if I let him. Y'all go fuck yourselves. There we go. Okay, waterbending?
I can feel my energy coming back.
I appreciate that they use, like, the show animations. Or at least, like, the artwork.
I got my water bending back.
Me. Oh, no, fuck you guys. Okay. Okay, less confidence needed on my part now that I have bending. There we go. Nope, oh, alright. Interesting. Okay, so it's good to vary up. Hello, Earthbender.
Crush you.
And now triads are here too?
Come on, get up. Wow, he just ate shit. Okay. Alright, having bending back. Very nice. Not much to be done there. I don't have a lot of combos or anything. One way or another, I got it. Fair enough. Alright.
That old man is trying to stop with those barriers. Well, I'm getting in one way or the other.
There we go.
Gotta make sure the temple is okay. Tenzin will blame me if something happens to it.
That's pretty nice. Okay, so I've got a bit of range on my B button attack with water bending. Good to know. Well, I've got a bit of range, period, huh? Wait, what? That seems like a little bit of an excessive range to be doing that at. Oh, fantastic.
Had enough for you?
I don't remember how the Korra universe works exactly. I don't know if water counters fire. Oh, the answer is clearly that fire counters water.
Here I come.
Wait, what? Oh.
Not giving up.
Okay. Good thing I bought that. It's a good tool for learning. Okay, waterbending is my long range style. But playing keep away is probably an. Okay. Let's get rid of those two. Hello, other guys. That was a little bit cheap. Yeah, I think you can set up some cool stuff with that, though. I appreciate it. Okay, heal up a little bit. Oh, hello. Oh, I remember those things. I see they're prepared.
Get ready for a beating.
Oh, great.
This is worse than I thought. The temple's been invaded.
Ow! Okay, I need to pick one. Ow. Okay. Okay, get the fuck out. Oh, you're my new target.
Triads and cheat blockers working together? What is going on?
Okay, those guys are out of the picture. Note to self, that can't be blocked.
I can
do okay.
This.
Okay. Note to self. Fight the Earthbender, because he's crazy strong. Oh, whoops, I can't skip that.
Get ready for a beating, Missy. Worse than I thought. The temple's been invaded.
Hey, how do I do that? I don't have that. Oh, now I don't have any items, though. Yeah, all my other bending is blocked.
Triads and cheat blockers working together? What is going on?
Waterbending really is not my thing, I think. get out. Okay, only one left, right? Wait, I'm an idiot. I haven't been dodging at all. My life just got 100% easier. Okay, there we go. Okay, much better. Yeah, alright, whenever you use the dodge mechanic, things probably work much better. Okay, that's completed. Dun dun dun. Alright, so, at this point I'm going to assume that the game takes a little bit to get going. And, I'm going to do sort of a wrap-up type thing whenever I have, whenever I've gotten all the bending, I think I will finish up my first impressions. I think that's what I'm going to do. Okay, now we're back. I have unlocked all the bending, and, well, I just got airbending, so its level is not very representative of, what I might see later, but for now, basically how it breaks down is that each different element is a weapon type, which being water's ranged, as we saw. Earth is your heavy hitting close range, and by heavy hitting, I mean it is extremely heavy hitting. It has that one range of attack. Devastating. Heavy hitting. Fire is your close range, super speedy attack. It's pretty good. It's not to my liking, but it's very good when fighting one very strong enemy. I can say that. And then air seems to be, for the most part, your deal with tons of tiny enemies type of moveset. Overall, I, of course, just because of the way I play games, I really enjoy earthbending. Because, like, huge, heavy-hitting, slow attacks are, like, my shtick in, like, all video games. So that really appeals to me, which is why it's so higher, like, so much of a higher level than the rest of these. Like, I got earthbending second, and it's two levels above the first one I got. So it is quite effective. So far, I came back to this level to show some things off. I decided that since I didn't want to show a later, more difficult level, I'm going to kind of like try and show off as much as I can with some of the early moves that you get. There are plenty of moves to unlock. And the charge system is actually pretty good. Provided you don't get knocked out of it. Also, being able to change powers like very, very quickly is really good. Also, rocket boots are hilarious to me. And I can't get enough of that shit. Because it's silly and I love it. Overall, I'd say right now I'm 5 levels in, not counting the ones with the running dog thing. Or running dog thing. Not counting the ones with Naga. I am 5 levels in, and on level 5 is where I acquired airbending. Oh, get them out of here.
So, you start getting into the more difficult enemies and, like, larger swarms, and then the first boss you fight becomes a regular enemy that just shows up. Enemy types get a little bit more varied later on. I am going to go, I think, and maybe show off, like, one section by itself of, like, a bunch of enemies and, like, a boss-type character. Not, he's a boss earlier on, and then later on you fight him as just, like, in with the rest, basically. But I might show that separately from this, and it might be, like, just inserted right here for the rest of the things that I say. And I think that, overall, it's really fun. If you enjoyed... I'd say if you were someone who enjoyed Rising, or enjoyed... I can't really rightfully say Bayonetta, because I actually never finished Bayonetta, but I can pretty safely say that if you enjoyed Bayonetta, you're probably going to like this. And... I mean, there's not a lot to say. It's like, it's a platinum title. It seems pretty good so far. There's not any, like, I haven't encountered any weird glitches. It seems pretty on the key so far. And I mean, besides that, there's not a ton to say, really. It's fun. Right now, this game is like a baby version of, like, fucking awesome, like, AAA tier platinum game, which is just fine. For $15, I'd say even so far, this game has been, like, totally worth it. It's given me exactly what I paid for. Or rather, exactly what I wanted for what I paid. Also, the story stuff seems like it's pretty neat. It doesn't seem like it's, like, too crazy, and I mean, it's canon, so that's good. For people who want more of the story, it seems like a good experience. The cutscenes that I did watch, I went back and watched some cutscenes. They seem like they're good in, like, the animation department, and, like, they get things done, and they don't seem, like, super cheap or anything like that to me. And I've overall enjoyed them. So, I'd say so far... Oh, I did not know I could do this. I have a hover with airbending, evidently. Can I do that with all the elements? Not with this one. Obviously not with Earth. Oh, okay, that's unique to airbending. I had no idea. Yeah, you have a hover. Neato. Huh.
Chi blocker has never blocked my bending for this long before.
And
like my chi is completely gone. What did that old guy do to me?
This system right here, where you can charge up your attacks, actually is really, really cool. Like you get, like, very powerful stuff. And with earthbending, because I have it leveled, I've gotten, like, the level 2 charging. It's, like, this is very strong, and it feels, like, really awesome to execute the abilities like this. Like, you just, like, just basic attacks, like, the more you do it, like, the more powerful your, like, attacks get. Like, this is, like, this right here, those, like, enemies that were the first boss show up, and this just takes them down. Like, it is so incredibly strong, and, like, it feels really good to play. And, like, as someone who enjoys a very, like, heavy playstyle, I was the kind of person that, if you've played Rising, I really enjoyed, like, the, like, pincer blades. Those were awesome, just because I like heavy, hard-hitting weapons. Granted, I like the other weapons as well in that game, and I like the other styles in this game, but it's a preference, I think. And I think if you're someone that enjoys, like, fast, dodgy attacks, you're probably going to really enjoy fire. It seems like it's got a lot going for it. Air seems like it's kind of something that anyone can enjoy. It seems pretty powerful, and it's got its own thing going for it. It's got some, like, AoE type stuff, and if you're someone that likes to back off and stay at range, water's got, like, what you need. But for me, Earth is my deal, so that's the one I've spent the most time with. But I think I could easily recommend this. And because I've been playing on normal, I did go back and I did one level on easy. I think it was like level 3, I think? That sounds right. That is a way easier difficulty. It's not punishing in, like, any regard, really. I found it to be, like, just simple, just to, like, mash through any enemy that came upon me. And so if you're someone that probably just wants to maybe like get a little more Korra in your life, it's probably going to be a fun experience in that respect too. And maybe you'll find a new type of game that you like. Platinum makes some good Vidge games and you might enjoy them. So I think that's going to be about it. It's a good game. I'm happy with it so far.